to which the organs of the eye tend to react to. It is an illuminating agent or enlightenment in which an object seems to take on a certain appearance. I want you to understand that light is the object of darkness, because when light appears, darkness tends to disappear. Darkness tends to distort the vision of an object and prevent the sight organ from the ability to be able to see. The term light and darkness in the Bible has been equated with spiritual understanding. That is, light meaning righteousness and pure. It means holiness. It means the character of God when we talk about light. But when we talk about darkness, it denotes the unrighteousness or the evil. It denotes sin. It talks about the works of Satan and his demons and those things that are opposite of what God really stands for. God created man in a state of illumination, of light, of purity, of righteousness, and of holiness when he made him and placed him in the Garden of Eden. Man was that vessel that God could identify with and relate to simply because he was made in the likeness and in the image of God. Satan came and distorted that light that was in man by persuading him and Eve, man, Adam and Eve, to disobey God and cause mankind to be in a state of sin and walking in darkness away from God. Matthew 4 and 16 declare unto us that we sat in darkness and we had no hope, but Jesus came and brought great light unto us. In our text that is given unto us today, John declared that the Word was with God and it was in him was life. And that because it was in him was life, he was the light of the world. He came to light up what God, the enemy had taken out of man, what God had put in him, and we find that he began to place in man what Satan had taken away. The light that we talk about is the light that shineth in darkness, that, and the darkness apprehended it not. When Jesus came, the world could not understand Jesus and his coming. They could not understand. And even now, they still do not have an understanding of what Jesus is all about. There are religious people that believe in religion or deity, but yet they don't understand Jesus and what Jesus brought to the world. Not only do we talk about other religions, but there are some individuals that consider themselves to be Christians, but yet they do not understand the light that Jesus brought to us and the change that caused in our lives. Jesus was the true light, and that lighteth every man that cometh into the world if they would receive him and accept him as their Lord and Savior. Therefore, every man, girl, and boy, then we have the opportunity to live a righteous life, a holy life, a life of purity, a life that is likened unto the character of God. We that have accepted him into our lives, we can identify and we can agree that it illuminates our character. Therefore, we come to the point of understanding, because Christ is in us, he shines in us in the sin that would abide within us. It is distorted because Christ lives in us. Therefore, the world should be able to see Christ in us. As we go about our daily lives, as you go about shopping, as you go here and there, the world should be able to see a difference in your life. the life of those that are in the world. Somebody tell the Lord, thank you. Jesus said unto us, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. The world is in need of seeing a light. The world needs to see an example of righteousness. There are so many things that are going on now. I turn my TV to the news and I hear of bad things happening. Young men, young ladies that are committing crime and they really messing up their lives at a young age. Then they're going to have to spend the rest of their lives behind bars simply because they were walking in darkness and didn't realize what Satan was doing in their lives. But the world needs to see a light. And the only way that they are going to be able to see a light is by the life in which we live and the service in which we give. Therefore, we should work on our lives and make sure that we are the light that Jesus has requested of us to be. Zacharias prophesied and said that it through the tender mercy of God, whereby the day spring from on high has visited us to give light to them that sat in darkness and in the shadows of death, to give our feet unto the way of peace. Now he has called you out of darkness into this marvelous light. Paul began to ask the question and said, what shall separate us from the love of God? Shall we continue in sin? In darkness shall we continue in it? Or whereas grace may abound? He came back and answered the question and said, God forbid. God said no. Now that we have come into the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we were at some time in darkness. We walked in sin, but now ye are in the light. So since you are in the light, then you should walk as children of light. You should let your light shine. Let your light shine that others may see the good works in you. We sing the song, say, this little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. Sometimes